2004, a new wood-boring beetle was detected in Southern California and now threatens oak trees across the region and state. Called the gold-spotted oak borer, the tiny insect kills trees from the inside out.
It is native to Arizona, I think the southeastern area of Arizona, where it feeds on silverleaf oak, on Murray oak. So in California are two main species that it attacks and actually causes significant mortality in are canyon live oak and coast live oak.
I mean, you're talking coast live oak. This is a beautiful tree. It grows in very specific areas. You know, if you start losing it, you know, by especially the big ones, you know, like it attacks the big ones first, which is horrible. You know, I mean, you have this tree in your backyard, you've grown up with it, you love it, you know, you want to see your children play on it and stuff, and next thing you know, it's gone in a matter of months.
It's a very emotional thing having to tell someone that what they've known for their entire lifetime is changing very rapidly. So kind of dealing with a mourning stage or grief period of, oh, I'm losing things that are significant to me.
One community affected by the beetle is Green Valley, a small mountain town in Los Angeles County.
The reason we moved up here was for the oak trees. We actually spent 2 years just about looking for the perfect buildable property that had enough room to build and still keep the oak trees on there. That's why we moved up here, is the greenage that we get year-round from our beautiful oak trees.
Now those trees are at risk. Unless it's aggressively managed, the gold-spotted oak borer can kill 80 to 90% of mature oaks in areas it infests.
So they'll lay the egg. The egg will hatch. A small larva will actually bore into and down into, through the outer bark and into the cambium of the tree, where that tree is moving nutrients and water through those living tissues. So it takes advantage of that protected habitat where they're nice and cozy and have a lot of nutrients. So you can see then as they bore through that healthy tissue, they're actually girdling the tree little by little.
When those tunnels completely wrap around the trunk, the tree can no longer move nutrients and water, and it dies. One thing researchers have discovered is that the beetles don't spread out evenly in an infested area.
We have amplifying trees in these woodlands, and an amplifying tree will have 3,000 beetles in it, when the normal tree seems to have maybe 15 or 20 or maybe no more than 100. So when you start talking about those numbers, removing a tree that's an amplifying tree, or making sure that it gets the greatest amount of treatment to keep adults from emerging into the rest of the oak woodland, becomes really, really important.
Sometimes you'll have, you know, pupation chambers that are almost stacked on top of each other. There's so many. There's another one. See, they've got one right there and one right there, all just inches of each other. Once they're in this state, they're not going to recover. They're going to continue downhill no matter how much rain you get, no matter how much anything you do. You could spray this thing, it's not going to recover. Spraying this thing at this point is trying to, you know, encapsulate the beetles and keep them from spreading on to new trees.
The best way to protect healthy trees is to cut down infested ones and strip the bark away to burn or chip.
Last winter, we decided to cut down dying oak trees, both canyon live oak and coast live oak, knowing that oaks have the ability to resprout. And so we thought that we could promote these resprouts so that instead of the trees dying, that we have future generations of oaks growing here in Cuyamacaranja State Park. When we have this, you know, massive die-off over the coming 10, 15, 20 years of these oak trees, what's going to replace? Is it going to be non-native annuals? Is it going to be more chaparral? We don't know. We just know that it's not going to be these, you know, really pristine or these really vast mature forests that people who have been coming to Cuyamaca for decades, have been coming here for generations, remember this park being. It's gonna be very different.
And not just for campers. There are 29 federally recognized Native American tribes in Southern California with their own special relationship with oaks.
The oak trees have been a part of our culture for many generations. In our creation stories, oak trees were one of the fundamental elements that were first here on the land. The acorn is one of the ingredients that we need to make what is called weewish, which was the main staple in our food for our people.
I'm working with tribes to develop management plans with the ultimate goal of having action items in place once gold-spotted oak borer does show up on tribal land. What's happened to some tribes in Southern California is we find this invasive pest and the tribe can't react quick enough in order to implement a plan before the beetle flies and then goes back into the tree, a different tree, and continues to kill oak trees. So what these management plans do is they put a decision in place and it's able to be approved by tribal councils before GSOP moves into an area.
Another community fighting the beetle is Oak Grove in northern San Diego County.
Last year, together with our neighbors, we treated, sprayed, or dealt with the infected trees. We dealt with over 900 trees here in Oak Grove, and now we're out here this spring to this year to identify other trees for treatment.
In Green Valley, state, federal, and county agencies are cooperating to combat the beetle, and a lot of infected trees are being removed.
Gosh, I'd say about at least 75% of the trees here, 70% of the trees in this area are gonna come down.
We've been monitoring a lot of the oak trees, trying to capture how many trees have been infected, how many trees are stressed out, as well as inventorying trees that look healthy for the next year. And we've also done the operation side of it, cutting down trees that are what we consider our host trees, and processing them by removing the bark and chipping the bark.
You take a round of wood and you put it on a splitter and you cut off all the sections of bark simply by turning it, splitting it, turning it, and splitting it off.
The main problem with GSOP is moving it, you know, through firewood. And a lot of people just sometimes take it and think that, oh, I don't have any of these trees around my house, therefore I'm okay, you know. And still within a couple of months, you know, you realize that you have another outbreak on your hands, you know. So our biggest fear is things like that. It mainly moves through humans moving it, you know. So we need to spread as much education about that as possible to get people aware of this threat. It's the last thing you want is to bring it up to Yosemite or anything like that, you know. And I always have that in the back of my mind, or just whenever I see a truck going down the road, it's like, oh my gosh, where's it going?
And the problem is that one truckload of wood is what started this. They know where this came from San Diego area, and they know how it was brought up here. It was one pickup truckload of wood about 5 to 7 years ago, and that's, and now we're off to the races.
The areas with significant infestations become denuded. Most of the trees have to be removed, and that's both a lot of work and makes a big change to the landscape.
We've seen a drastic die-off of our mature oak trees, which is going to have a massive impact on the ecosystem as a whole, which affects everything from our large mammals, deer, turkey, bobcat, mountain lions, down to insects, herps, small mammals, birds. It's going to have an effect on the watersheds.
I mean, it could really turn this into more of a desert area than what it is, and that would be a shame.
To try to keep that from happening, researchers want to understand what keeps gold-spotted oak borer in check in its native habitat. Is it the species of oaks found there, or the monsoonal summer rains in the desert southwest? Or is there a natural enemy to the beetle?
The thing we really need to do is find a pest that will attack it without attacking other things. And I think we need a significant research approach on this, because I think otherwise it's going to be very, very hard on the entire environment. It's going to change it dramatically.
We can only delay GSOP, and we really have to let the science continue to catch up. give us the management tools that we need.
Yeah, containment is key. We already have it here. Let's keep it here and hopefully eradicate it.